we knew that we had to make changes within the squad. There was so many contracts up, and we've ended up bringing 12 new players in. So as a team, we're evolving all the time, and we just need to keep improving each game.
I think if you speak to every Villa fan out there, they're excited by the football after they were playing and attacking. I think certain games you have to be a bit more cautious.
Because he's 24 now, I thought we'd be seeing this Jack Grealish at 21, but he showed his loyalty to Villa and he's brought him back up, you know.
And he works hard as well. We've got these stats on dribbling. Yes. It's not just about the flair stuff.
He's matured. He's finding people at the right time. He's carrying the team. He's the main focal point. The only question for me is whether he becomes as good as I.
Take an awful lot. I mean, I've just said in there, we can learn lessons from today, but we can also learn from City and how they play. I mean, they use the space behind the back line so well. Raheem Sterling's timing and speed of his running. But without the ball as well, they get a shift. They're so compact and they move so quickly to force you back with them.
For the week, to me, this is the most talented player we've seen since Gaza. He's got everything.
For me, will be staying up. I think just try and look at staying up this season, and then in the summer they can rebuild. They've got owners who they want to get into Europe, so they can rebuild, maybe get a few more faces in the door in the summer, and then try and push on again. There's no reason why Villa can't look at Wolves and how they've got into Europe. Why not?
Try and get enough points to survive in this league, and they've found themselves in the bottom three now.
Yes.
You know, you're now playing under pressure. Expectant crowd, they have spent money, and it looks like they might have a go at you.
Let's get to the Premier League headquarters, as promised, because meetings were held this morning in response to the escalating corona pandemic.
It was obviously the classic screen that we never want to see when it comes to club statements. Should you be stripped of the captaincy? I've seen a few things on Twitter. For me, like I said, it's not the actions of a captain, and
I don't see him staying there if they're going to be relegated, and it looks as if we are, unless something dramatic happens. I mean, defensively, they concede so many goals and have done all season that I don't see them getting out of it.
And what I saw from Villa today, again, yes, they need more in the last third.
Manchester United at home in the week, Palace at home, Everton away, Arsenal at home, West Ham away. Would you be backing them?
Nope.
Here's a chance, tries again, Of us, and we know that we're getting to the stage of the season where only a win will do. And listen, we're still nowhere near out of the woods yet, but we've given ourselves a good chance, and we have to go and replicate it next week, and it'll be another tough game.
You're in charge of your own destiny now. You know, they go to West Ham, they just need a result, and they're safe in the Premier League.
Could this have been your last game in a Villa shirt at Villa Park?
I have one aim, and that's to keep this club in the Premier League. I think where this whole stadium, this whole club and fan base, you know, knows where we belong. So that's all I'm thinking about at the moment. Like I said, yeah, keeping this club in the Premier League, and hopefully we can do that.
A draw might be enough, but I wouldn't like to guarantee that. I don't think that I wouldn't want to go to West Ham and sit back and hope and wait for the other teams, because we know what it's like on the last day of the season.
It's John McGinn. Find it, Grealish. Grealish! Wow. Stunning! Scintillating! Surviving! Aston Villa's captain leaves his club legacy. It's Jack Grealish.
Is the confirmation that Aston Villa are in the Premier League for another season. After 34 games of this 38 game season, they were going down. Unbeaten in their final four means it's celebrations on the pitch for Aston Villa.
Why? Not going to ever win anything.
They just stayed in the Premier League.
No, listen, like delighted. That, listen, Dean Smith, he's made a good point. We've said it before. There was a big change at the club last summer. It was going to take time. They've stayed up. A big achievement. Celebrations, listen, slightly over the top, but good luck to them.